So it's time for the nav chips. I have 3 out of 4 so far. Let's start with the lab entry one. Mind you, in order to access these stages, I need to have a few upgrades, so there may be some forest part usage. What I'll likely be doing is finishing these stages then ending the stream, but we'll see. They look to be bonus stages. When I first started this game, I thought credits would be hard to come by. Lo and behold, it's the exact opposite. This is essentially a combination of the lab stage with another stage. We have the ice and gravity gimmicks combined with the water raising and lowering. If this pattern holds, that means that the two following stages will be combinations of two different sets of levels. Although the graphics are more on the simplistic side and look a tad flat, they're serviceable. I simply wish some of the foreground platforms stood out more from the background. Super version of the enemy. The prologue boss was also an upgraded version of a regular enemy. In that case, it was a regular foot soldier. Oh, I see, Jaden. That applies too. Don't let it snow. Itenbaal's Brawn Bro Metal Foundry. So, combination of the foundry and when I first encountered the stage select screen, I thought the 6 stages would be fairly short. Oh, this stage fell shorter. Not Illumina's back for revenge. This was a giant Forge minibot. Those red dark spark looking things are likely what led to the rise in Nadros. Double tap for good measure. Maintenance tunnel number 6, employees only. Okay, this is actually a combination of the sewers and something else. The previous stage was a combination of the train and the forge. Based off the music, this is a combination of the sewers and the simulation lab. Yep, and this only confirms it. Something I neglected to mention during the previous stage, the soundtracks of the two stages were combined to make the secret songs. At least to a small extent. And I was getting a tad worried that Panda wasted their money. See you again. This looks scarier. Bring back your fangs, please. No, I'm not going for it. This game loves its fakeouts. See? Cool, we play as him now. He's very likely an unlockable. He has his own health bar and power meter. All together now. Open wide. Yet again, the game plays with our expectations. Not only with the fakeouts and bosses with different mechanics, but even separate characters. We did chop it down to size. Another Nav chip? Must be the final one. MD_1. Notice how everything has a bit of a sepia filter to it. And there's no music. So a survival gauntlet. Can I survive 30 rounds? Infinite power. Sometimes we have enfeeblements, sometimes we have massive buffs. I suppose these buffs and nerfs are randomized, as well as each individual arena. The game's music looping could do with some improvement. There are some very noticeable restarts. Let's quickly discuss some game lore. Seeing how humanity is on the losing side of a war, and how this training simulation is on a Nav Chip, I get the strong impression that this was designed during a pre-war era. I never played that game, so I'll take your word for it. I don't have any healing in between trials either. Seconds is plenty. That is with all these upgrades. Every 5 floors is dedicated to a different stage type. A robot named Fight is a roguelite, is it? Or a procedural death game? In order to get through this faster, I'll simply rely on the light rifle and buster now. So it's more like dead cells. I do regenerate some health per level. And last but not least is the forest simulation. I do have E-tanks, by the way. I'll use them when necessary. Last floor. We're out. Source suit acquired. So the Infinity Plus 1 armor. However, for the final set of stages, I'll be toggling it off after a short while. I don't want to completely destroy this game's challenge. I'll be entering those towers during the next stream. Well then, thanks for watching, and have a nice day.